In many instances, the anger, the hatred, the resentment goes away the first time. But it seems to be some kind of a spiritual principle involved here, that when I pray for you, I cannot at the same time maintain my hatred for you. And eventually, what was hatred turns to love. This is a spiritual dynamic for which we have no scientific proof. All of our evidence comes from what we do and what others tell us they have done. It's anecdotal. There's no way to measure this, but we know it's true. I cannot stay angry with you and hate you if I'm praying for you. Think how important this is to understand, that we can be set free from our resentments if what we're willing to do is to pray for the person we resent and ask God to give them everything that we would want for ourselves. Thousands upon thousands upon thousands of people have been doing this ever since this was written, and it works. The people I sponsor all know this page, and they know what they need to do anytime they get angry. Yes?
Let's say that you're angry with somebody and you decide you're going to pray for them, and you stop praying for them, and by the third, fourth day, you don't have the resentment anymore. You still have to pray for them for 2 weeks?
No. Only until it's gone, Billy.
Some people I don't really like, you know.
As tasty as this anger and resentment, justified anger is, we have to let go of it. It's not doing a thing to hurt them, is it?
No.
What's it doing to you?
It's destroying you.
The best revenge you can have on them is to live. Live happily, yes.
Well, be kind to them.
You got to do that. You want to really tear them up? Be kind to the person who harmed you. They won't know what the hell to do then. Yes. Did you have your hand up? Oh, okay. If someone is being nasty, rotten, and mean to you, you go like this. They ask you what you're doing. You say, "Vengeance is mine, saith the Lord. I'm praying to stay around long enough to see what he's going to do to you." There's a prayer that really works. Now there's one other thing. Yes?
I just wanted to comment one thing that I found really helpful in this part that you said some time back. There's two good things to learn how to say when somebody's offending you. The first thing is, You know, being able to go, and pause and not retaliate is very, very important. And with employers particularly, okay.
Yeah, okay.
That is a wonderful word.
With strong positive inflection, okay.
Yeah.
Now you can follow up, if you wish, in special circumstances. That's very interesting. That's interesting. It's very difficult to keep up a diatribe when it's not being responded to. Now here's one other thing before we close. Oh, yes.
I've found in a lot of conversation situations,
what?
You may be right.
Oh yeah, you may be right. Mm-hmm. You can say under your breath, I'm pretty sure you're not, but there's nothing wrong with being just a little outrageous, you know, shameless about this stuff. And there's no requirement that we go around being brutally honest in the face of being attacked. That's a good way to get brutalized, not just with words. So what we do is we recognize that our job is to be kind and loving toward all. And that's the way we do it. And when we do that, we find that we just get along fine. Now then, there's one other thing that's involved here, guys, and it's called forgiveness. And it goes back to our the prayer we say at the end of each meeting, which we ask God to forgive us our trespasses. In other words, forgive the wrongs that we've done, just as and to the like extent that we are willing to forgive others. who have harmed us. And just as with everything else in our program, we find out that first there is something that we must do, and then God answers our prayers. There's always a condition precedent as we form our partnership with God. There are things that we do first, and then God does what He promises. And then we do what we're supposed to do, and God does what He promises. And here, we make doggone sure that we have forgiven the wrongs that others have done us. Then we can be assured of God's forgiveness of the wrongs that we've done, our trespasses. Now, one other thing I'd like to mention to you. When you're counseling your sponsee about this, it would be wise to suggest to them that they ask God for the willingness to forgive, because there seems to be a tremendous amount of difficulty in arriving at a place of forgiveness ourselves without the intervention of God. But the other side of the coin is very bright. If I ask God for the willingness to forgive the wrongs of others, it will come. The willingness results in forgiveness. They must be just that close, just a membrane apart, because the willingness comes and the forgiveness is always there. So there's a kind of an interesting way of arriving at this forgiveness. We simply pray for the willingness. Yes?
My name's Charles. I'm going to call.
Yes, Charles.
Jim, I want to ask you a question. You know, in the ninth step, we made direct amends to such people wherever possible.
Yes.
Except when to do so to injure them or others.
Yes.
You know, I'm going through a situation now. I'm just going to keep this brief. But, it's probably a good question. I have something going on with me where I'm dishonest, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And I try to justify that, too.
Yeah, it doesn't work.
But it's the secret that's bothering me, and I don't want to confront the person either.
Well, if you were to confront the person, would you harm them?
I may harm myself.
Well, that's not relevant. If it causes harm to you, remember you agreed to go to any lengths to be set free from alcohol, right? I'm not going to try to advise you on it. You've got a sponsor. Lay the whole thing in your sponsor's lap, and the two of you discuss it and pray about it and see what God wants you to do. As a general rule, is all I can deal with here. Wherever we can make amends without harming the other person, we're required to do so. It may be that making amends might hurt a third party, and again, the step says we can't do that either. A good general rule, if you're making amends, let's say to somebody with whom you had a long-term relationship, to sit down and parade all the horribles and make them relive the horrors of the past would not be good. That could cause great pain for them. So sometimes you don't want to do that at all. You want to make your amends very general. But each case is different. And each one, the only thing that's important at this stage is for you to be willing to make amends where you can. And you sit down with your sponsor and with God and you work out the amends that you need to make. Okay? You'll find that it comes pretty clear. Okay, I want to thank all of you so much for being here. And anybody need to... Well, we need to pay the rent, don't we? I keep forgetting about that. Anybody who